Mimi niliwaambia nilipambana na Uhuru Kenyatta akiwa rais wa Kenya, nikiwa tu mbunge wa kawaida. Wewe usijaribu kufikiria ati unaweza nitisha sababu uko na cheo inakaribia rais hapo. Mimi hakuna mtu anaweza nitisha hii Kenya na hii dunia. Niliwaambia naogopa Mwenyezi Mungu peke yake, uji moto na umeme peke yake.
Wewe suti wewe. Saa hii unaingia kwa mitambo, unaandika hapo at 2 weeks. Nimekuona huko kwa mitambo huko. Umeandika 2 weeks. Wewe kwanza huku soma wewe.
An impeachment of a deputy president, from my experience as a former leader of majority, who was there when Amos Kimunya was impeached, who was there when Moses Wetangula was impeached, who was there when Minister Kaimenyi survived, I was there when the process of impeaching Anwar Iguru was there. It's not a birthday party. It's not a walk in the path. And you look at the person who is driving this. You go.
If there is anybody who is going home, he's the one who bought the first ticket to go home. And I want to say here, musifikiria sisi watu wa mlima hatuna viongozi ambao wanaongoza. Tuko na kipiki kizuri. Muongoza bibi ya mjumbe wake. Mnashika hiyo maneno? Mnashika hiyo maneno? Mimi ni mimi bibi ya mjumbe wao. Amekataliwa mpaka nyumbani.
Hello and welcome to PDM Digital TV. My name is Peter and here is the political insider on Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua impeachment motion. Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua and his allies have sustained their onslaught against President William Ruto's camp, even as the rift within the ruling Kenya Kwanza administration widens. Speaking on Saturday during a church service in Thika, Gachagua warned Ruto that if the United Democratic Alliance Party is not put in order, then he risks losing the trust of the Mount Kenya people and that nothing can be done to salvage the situation.
Hii maneno ya mipango ya kuumiza wengine na kutatiza wengine, hiyo maneno ukiniliza haina haja. Kwa sababu sisi tulipewa miaka 5 tufanye kazi. Na kama iko shida kwa boma, mzee mwenye boma ataketi chini na bibi zake na watoto atatue. Lakini tukianza kutengana, I want to caution that the direction that is being taken ya kubomoa hii nyumba yetu, hii nyumba ikibomoka haitarudi tena. That is the truth. That action people are planning, wakisaidiwa na watu hawakuwa na sisi, ikivuja hii boma ya UDA, haitaweza rudi tena.
Referencing the difficulty Ruto endured during his time as the deputy president, Gachagua said that no one will ever trust him again if he, in question, Ruto allows his allies to humiliate him.
I want to ask my brother, my Vice President William Ruto, to be cautious and do the right thing. Let's keep our house together. Let us not be destructive. And let us not reintroduce the politics of betrayal. President William Ruto is the greatest beneficiary of the peoples of Mount Kenya distant for betrayal. Our people hate betrayal and they are very unforgiving if you betray them.
Speakers at the service, who included Marara, Gathonwa Mushoba, Karugo Adhanwa, and Major Donk, argued that if the motion is tabled in parliament, then Ruto must have authorized it and okayed it. Gachagua warned that Ruto is risking losing the support of the Mount Kenya region if his allies go ahead with the impeachment plan.
The other day I asked the president to keep one promise to the people of Kenya that requires no funding, requires no IMF, requires no World Bank. He promised the people of Kenya that under his watch, his deputy will never be humiliated. Didn't he promise? We are asking him to keep that promise. If he can't keep that one promise, nobody can trust him to keep any other promise. So it's up to him, as he will, if we go into that direction. these people will be very unforgiving. That's just my advice. It doesn't have to be taken. I've been around for a long time. Mimi nimekuwa hapo wakati ya Moi, nimekuwa hapo wakati ya Kibaki, nimekuwa hapo wakati ya Uhuru. Sasa niko hapo, mimi najua mambo mawili matatu. Hii watu ya Mlima Kenya, mimi nawaelewa sana. Kisaliti hii watu, uhusiano yako na hawa itafika mwisho. Huyo huyo Mungu alisimama na Rais William Ruto. Hakuna bahali ameenda. Si yako tu. That is my comfort. Ya kwamba huyo Mungu, hakuna bahali ameenda. He's still there. So let us see how things unfold.
The political wars facing Deputy President Gachagua look at a different turn on Monday when Tana River Senator Danson Mugatana filed censure motion against the number two in command. Mr. Mugatana filed the motion with Senate Speaker Amason Kingi, accusing that Gachagua is conducting himself in a manner that does not benefit the stature of the office of the Deputy President. The lawmaker has taken issue with what he terms as Mr. Gachagua, a regional focus, yet he's a member of Kenya's presidency and should focus on and serve the entire country, not just a region. Unlike an impeachment motion that seeks to remove an office holder, debate on a censure motion involves members expressing strong opinions of disapproval against the targeted individual. Mr. Mugatana's motion, if approved, will see lawmaker discuss his conduct in the plenary of the Senate. He said that the censure motion should strongly show disapproval with the conduct of Mr. Gachagua, whom he accused of behaving as if he is the Deputy President of Mount Kenya Region. He said the Constitution is clear in that one cannot be a holder of any national office and be a leader of a county or a region.
Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya has been conducting himself as if he belongs to only one region of the Republic of Kenya, to the exclusion of other regions of the Republic of Kenya, to the exclusion of other counties such as Tana River County in the Republic of Kenya. So this is a censure motion which I have filed today with the office of the Speaker of the Senate. They will process it. Once we get approval, we shall table it before the House, give notice of the motion, and debate the censure motion.
Mr. Mugatana accused Mr. Gachagua of behaving as a co-president instead of working as the principal assistant to President William Ruto. The censure motion comes in the wake of Mr. Gachagua last week painted a strained relationship with his boss. Speaking on a Citizen TV interview on Friday, September 20th, Mr. Gachagua said that any move to remove him, which he said could only come from President William Ruto himself, could destabilize the country. In the TV interview, Mr. Gachagua opened up about a plot to impeach him, even as he revealed that such a motion can only come to Parliament upon the express approval of his boss, President Ruto.
That there is no motion of impeachment against the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya that can fight itself on the floor of the House unless the President of the Republic of Kenya gives a nod.
Okay.
And again, even if it was to go there, nobody else has the capacity to push it through. It's only the President himself. There is nobody else who can. Getting 233 members of Parliament, it's only him who can push it through.
He laid bare the past struggle that has rocked the two-year-old Kenya Kwanza administration, talking about plans to frustrate his involvement in government function. National Assembly Deputy Speaker Gladys Boss-Shore has sought to confirm a plan to impeach Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua. Boss further went on to assert that she will take charge of the impeachment process when the matter comes up to the National Assembly.
Mimi mwenyewe nitakupeleka nyumbani. I am putting you, Rigathi Gachagua, on notice. You are going to be impeached. I can confirm that to you today. And I shall be in charge of that impeachment myself.
Boss went on to tell resident of Uashinigishu County that President William Ruto will not have any problem when she's there.
And for those who have not understood, you know, they here at home, they call me Chebamuren, Iron Lady. So I'm telling them, don't worry, no one can touch Ruto when I am there.
Thank you for watching. We'll keep you updated on the Political Insider on this motion initiated by Tanariva Senator Dasson Mugatana. See you next time.